The plan to have every Australian vaccinated by Christmas now largely depends on getting Pfizer doses into the country after a surprise change in advice today. AstraZeneca will now only be recommended to people aged 60 and over in a major hit to the vaccine rollout.
Australia's medical experts have dealt another blow to the troubled vaccine rollout.
They have recommended an increase in the age range for those who should be using AstraZeneca from 50 to 60 and above.
After ruling in April that the locally made AstraZeneca should be limited to over 50s, the Immunisation Advisory Group today lifted the bar again, pushing up the preferred age by a decade.
We recognise that this is a conservative position, but relative to Australia's risk of having COVID.
That means measuring the vanishingly small risk of developing severe adverse effects from getting AstraZeneca against the currently even more remote chance of dying from COVID-19 in a country where there's almost no disease.
We accept the advice.
Of 3.8 million doses of AstraZeneca, there have been 37 confirmed cases of rare blood clots and 2 deaths. But in the last week, there have been 12 confirmed or probable cases of blood clots, 7 of which were in people aged between 50 and 59. And that has tipped the balance against the only vaccine manufactured here at a rate of 1 million doses a week.
AstraZeneca remains a very effective vaccine.
The advice on second doses is clear.
To those 3.8 million Australians who've had a first dose of AstraZeneca, go and get your second dose, however old you are.
The shifting sands are shaking the confidence of some.
Most of the people, they don't want to take the AstraZeneca.
But not all.
I'm still pretty comfortable with taking it, yeah.
While the opposition is keen to increase the government's pain.
The Prime Minister bet the house on AstraZeneca and now this rollout is in complete disarray.
The government's hope of vaccinating the nation by year's end now rests on importing 40 million doses of Pfizer.
We remain on track to receive all of our Pfizer during the course of this year.
As long as nothing else goes wrong. Chris Yulman, Nine News.